Now, when I was speaking to Cobra recently about their new drivers, one of the things they said about Cobra was that they make cool stuff that works. And you really can't disagree with them. I think their drivers have always been renowned for being very forgiving, being very fast on off-center hits, and that technology continues through from one model to the next. And this is what it is with the new F6 Ranger drivers. You've got the speed channel around the face, which is there to help the ball speed on those off-center hits, with the E9 face, which is renowned amongst a lot of fitters I know for being very good for increasing that ball speed. They've also got the smart pad on the sole, and this works with the adjustable hosel they have, which is their MyFlight 8 hosel, and that almost acts like a pivot point so that when you change the loft on the face, it still allows the face to be square. Now, MyFlight goes to a range of 4 degrees, it's got 5 settings, and it also has 3 draw settings within that. So typically on the driver, it's going from 9 degrees up to 12 degrees, and then the draw settings are on the half degrees, so 9.5, 10.5, and 11.5. So far so good. So what Cobra tried to do with the F6 Ranger drivers is to lower the center of gravity and get it close to the neutral axis. And this is a point, so imagine a line going perpendicular to the face to the back of the driver, and you want to get your center of gravity as close to that neutral axis point as you can, because that's going to give you the best results. Now, as I say, there's 3 models and I've got them all here, and we're going to take them over to the range and see what the differences are. So I'm going to start with the standard version. Now what this has is what they're calling a flip zone. You may remember on the FlyZ driver that we had before, the FlyZ Plus had a weight which you could flip back to front. Now, you don't have the sliding track to flip it on the F6, but what you do have is a single weight. It weighs 10 grams and you can alternate it between the back and the front position. And then when you have it in the opposite hole, there is a black plastic cap which covers the other one. Now, what this does is change the flight. When you have it in the back, it's gonna add some spin, and when you have it in the front, it's gonna take some off and give you a slightly lower flight. So let's see how it goes. I've got it in the back position here with 10.5 degrees aloft, which is about right for me. And it gives a lovely flight and a lovely sound there. And I think, you know, it's a lot better in that respect in terms of the feel and the sound. Now, when you put it down at address, it's a very similar head size. There's very little change in the shape of the head. It's all to do with how that weight is moved. And what they've done is really take a little bit of weight out of the top, put it more in the sole, and that gives you that space for the weight to give you that forgiveness. Okay, so that's the F6. I'm going to move on now to the F6 Plus. Now, as you see, this is a blue head. There is in all both models, there's a choice of 3 colors of head. You can have black, or glass black as they're calling it, or you could have blue, or you could have white, and they've got some fancy names for it which I'm not going to go into here. Now, the difference between the 2 colored versions is you've got a black face contrasting with the color on the head, which you don't have on the all black one. So if you like that contrasting for alignment, then the blue or the white option would be better. Now, the main difference with the F6 is that it's got a carbon crown rather than all titanium one, and it's also got a sliding weight going across a single track called the carbon track. And funnily enough, it's made of carbon. Now, in the previous track before, that was made of aluminium, and obviously that was a lot heavier than the carbon. So what they've done now is to actually save that weight, and that weight, which is about 8 grams saved, now goes into the sole weight. So instead of the sole weight being 10 grams before, it is now 18 grams. Now, that allows them to drop that center of gravity, as we talked about before, but now you've got 5 different points where you can move this weight from back to front. And they've kind of helpfully said, if you have it at the back, it gives you a towering flight, and if you put it at the front, it'll be penetrating. I haven't quite got that in that description just yet, but it definitely goes higher or lower. And whilst there are 5 positions numbered on here, you actually can put it in the half position as well. So it's actually 9 different positions. So there is an awful lot of flexibility. And also the channel, it doesn't go sort of directly front to back. It's on a slight angle, and that is there. So when the weight's at the back, it's as far back as it can possibly be. And again, when it's at the front, it's as far forward as it can possibly be. Now, again, I've got this set up with the weight in the back in 10.5 degrees, and I'll see how this one goes. Now, you might notice a slightly different sound there. It's a more sort of hollow sound. It's quite a solid sound too, and there's 2 reasons for that. One, because you've got the carbon in the crown, and that's going to make it sound a little bit different. And the other reason is that it's a much more compact head. It's not quite as deep front to back. Face is a little bit shallower as well. And of the two, I probably prefer this look. I'm probably going to say I prefer the sound and I prefer the feel of the other one. But we're going to come to this in a minute. This is not going to be relevant. Okay, but again, I think that's going to, it probably sounds more like the Fly Z drivers sounded in the past. Now, finally, we have an F6 Plus Pro. You're remembering all these names. Now, this is the same head as the F6 Plus, but what they've done is you've got a lower set of lofts. So with the adjustable My Fly 8 hosel on the other two drivers, you're going from 9 degrees to 12 degrees. On the Pro, it goes from 7 degrees to 10 degrees. Now that is because if you want a little less loft because you're spinning the ball too much, this is then going to give you that lower flight. So you've still got the sliding weight on the sole again. So in order to try and make this a fair fight, I've put the weight as far back as I can and I've put the loft as far up as it can go. So it's at 10 degrees, whereas the other two were 10 and a half. Now that gives a slightly sort of higher pitch sound, and the reason for that is because the weight's in a different place, and moving the weight around on the sole does change the sound and changes the feel a little bit as well. It does maybe feel a little bit lighter. I have to say, when I've had the weight at the front, it's probably when it sounds and feels the best, but performance-wise, it's better having it at the back. So, which one do you go for? Well, what you need to do is go to a Cobra fitter and get on a track man and see which one is the best for you, because it's really going to be about which driver chooses you and which one suits your game the best. Now, I put them all on track man, and whilst the results were very similar in a lot of the settings, the one that stood out for me, with about 100 mile an hour swing speed, which is what I do, sometimes a bit more on a good day, was the F6 Plus, because it was set up to maybe drop the little spin. And when I had that in 11 and a half degrees with the weight at the back, it was outperforming the F6 at 10 and a half degrees with the weight in the back as well. So that lower spinning head, but with more loft, was getting the ball up in the air. And because the ball's spinning less, it was going a little bit further. And for me, I was probably about 6 or 7 yards longer with the F6 Plus in that setting than the best setting from the F6. The shafts that come with it are very good. There are various options, but the standard one is this MS black tie shaft, which is very stable and very good indeed, and I think really complements the whole look of the F6 range. Overall, I have to say that I really like the F6. I think it's a big step up from the Fly Z drivers. I think they sound a lot better. I think they look a lot better as well. And you've got the extra flexibility. I mean, you've got essentially 5 settings on the hosel. You've got 9 positions for the weight on the Plus. So that gives you 45 on that head. You've got 10 settings on the F6. So it will give you plenty of options, and together with the shafts, you are going to find a model which will sit very well for you. You are going to pay 50 quid extra if you do get fitted into the F6 Plus, but I think it would probably be worth it for that performance. Certainly for me, I was getting a lot more distance, and I did prefer the look of it. As I said, I probably prefer the sound and feel of the F6, so you do have that trade-off, but that's the joys of driver fitting. Anyway, that's all for me today. So for more reviews on all Cobra golf equipment, please visit the website at golfalot.com.